Hello, my name is Edwin Cruz. I am going to tell you about digital portfolios. Each teacher and student is capable of having their own digital portfolio. First, I will explain the purpose of digital portfolios. You need to know if it's for student growth or to identify specific skills. They can be used to show parents student achievement. Now you will need to think about how to use it.
Thanks, Edwin. I am Amanda Peterson. Once you have digital portfolios going, decide how you will grade it. You can use a rubric, letter grade, or rating scale. Keep in mind that a portfolio is always a work in progress. Therefore, you might only grade a specific section. For example, in your language arts class you might grade a poem that was created. In a social studies, the project on modern-day slavery would be appropriate.
Thanks, Amanda and Edwin. I am Mandy Cuevas. Many teachers ask, what can be included in a digital portfolio? A working portfolio will include what students are currently working on. A display portfolio shows the student's best work. You may create a portfolio for one unit, but not the next. Students and teachers can choose what is included in the portfolio. Long-term and short-term projects are okay. One school does a project since Kinder.
Thanks, Amanda, Edwin, and Mandy. I am Diane. Now I will tell out how much to involve your students. The involvement in the portfolio will depend on the student's age. Make sure that students understand the purpose of the portfolio. Older students should be given a checklist of what is expected. Younger students can be given options of what to do. Collaboration is always encouraged. Students can do reflections just like in Interact.
Digital portfolios allow students to track and demonstrate their growth over longer periods of time. While paper portfolios get stored or discarded at the end of a term or school year, digital portfolios can remain available and easily accessible to students, parents, and educators. Do your best to implement a digital portfolio in your classroom. Finally, do not worry about formats such as Google, Wikispaces, and WordPress. Good luck.